Welcome back to Data Structures and Algorithms Tutorials by Edgemoon. In this video, we will see about binary search. The process used to find an entry in a group of data is known as search. Since searching is the most common activity in computing, it is desirable to find an efficient method for performing it. Perhaps the crudest search method is sequential or linear search, in which each item of the array is compared with the required or the searched element and it runs until the required value is found. So this is a time-taking or lengthy process. To overcome this, we have binary search. In the binary search, the given data is sorted into either ascending or descending order. The given data after sorted is divided into halves, continuously divided into halves. The middlemost value is the middle value. The given input is compared with the middle value. If it is equal to the middle value, then the answer is found at that position. If the value is less than the middle value, then left part of the array is being examined, or else the right part of the array is being examined. Repeatedly check until the value is found or the interval is empty. Now let us see the code for binary search using recursion. First, we'll create a function. In binary search, we'll pass a parameter array, int l, int r, and index. L is the left value of the array, r is the right value of the array, x is the item to be searched. First, we'll search our base case if right greater than or equals to l, then mid value equals to l plus r minus l by 2. This formula is used to find the mid value of the array. Now, we'll compare the mid value with the item to be searched, that is array of mid, that the value placed in the mid value position is compared with the x. If equals, then return x. If the value in the mid is more than the x, then we'll send array, then l, then r equals to mid minus 1. The rightmost value is equals to mid minus 1 and x, the item to be searched. Else, binary search will send the function array left value equals to mid plus 1 r x. We'll see with an example. See, if this entire case doesn't work, that is if r is less than l, then it will return minus 1, it indicates item not found. Yes, we'll take an example. We'll take an array size of 6 equals to let's take 4, 9, and 36, 52, 88, 96. 6 values, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yes. We'll little bit increase the size. 24, yes, okay. Now we'll give the index for this array 0, 1, 2 for 36, 3 for 52, space, yes, 4 for 88, and 5 for 96. Here we go. These are the indexes. Now, at first, we'll take the entire array and the leftmost value equals to 0, r equals to, wait, r equals to rightmost index of the array, that is equals to 5. And we will take, or we will search 88 in the given array, that is there in the fourth index position. So item to be searched, that is x equals to 88. Then we compare if r greater than or equals to l. Yes, now r is equals to 5, it's greater than or equals to 0. So we'll find the mid value. Mid value, we have a formula, mid equals to l plus r minus l by 2. So mid value equals to l, that is equals to 0, plus r minus l, 5 minus 0 by 2, that is equals to 5 by 2, that is equals to 2.5, and we are taking here integer type. So we only take the integer part and we'll leave the decimal part. So it is equals to 2. The mid value present in the position of 2 is 36. 36 is a mid value. Now 36 is compared with the x, that is equals to 8. So 36 is less than 88. 36 is less than 88. So 36 is less than 88. So we will return this function. So we will return array, then mid plus 1. Mid plus 1. So let's see here. Left equals to mid plus 1, that is equals to 1 mid. Yes. Now we will return left equals to this value, mid plus 1. See, mid here is 2. So 2 plus 1 equals to 3. Then R is center same. So R is equals to 5. And X, X equals to 88. Now we will compare again. Is R less than, it's less than L, R is equals to 5, and it is greater than L, that is equals to 3. So we will find the mid value. Mid value equals to L, that is equals to 3 plus R minus L, that is equals to 5 minus 3 by 2, that is equals to 2 by 2 is 1, 3 plus 1 is equals to 4. Yes, we have found it 4. Next, we have found the mid value. Now we will compare the mid value with 88 or x. So what is there in the fourth position? The value is 88. If array of mid equals to 88, yes, array of mid value is 88 equals to 88. So written mid equals to 4. So the answer is 4. The given value is found at position 4. This will be the output. If the answer is not found, the procedure will continue. See, if you want to sign 9, see, then the mid value at first here, at first index is equals to 2. That is equals to 36. That is means error of mid is greater than x. So 9 is 36 is greater than 9. So it will return r equals to mid minus 1. So it will send function r equals to mid minus 1. That is, mid is already 2. So 2 minus 1 will be sent. 1 will be r equals to 1. And the same process continues. When will this case will not occur? That means else case, when it will come else case. When R value is less than L, that means if the R value is less than L, means if R value becomes 0 or L value becomes more, then this case will occur. This is the recursion method. And next we will see the iterative method. In the iterative method, we will run a while loop. And same formula we use for finding the middle value. And same, if array of mid value equals to x, then it is m. If array of m less than x, then the leftmost value equals to m plus 1, else rightmost value equals to m minus 1. These values have been passed. See, if l greater than r, then it minus 1, no object found will be sent. This is the iteration method and binary method for binary search. In the next video, we will see about Tower of Hanai. Thank you.